Hey y'all, I'm Elisa, the Scrappy Wife behind ScrappyWife.com, and today I am working in my social media memory planner. And let me just explain what that is. So as someone that is a YouTube creator and is on social media a lot, I am working this year to do some memory keeping involved in that. And so that means recording all of the videos that I am publishing, Instagram posts. And then what I do is go back after decorating and I write in my favorite comments, the ones that really meant a lot. It's been a really good exercise for me just to focus on the good, because sometimes on YouTube and on Instagram, you get some negativity. And so this has been a great way for me to focus on the good. So this week I am going to focus on February 8th through the 14th, show you my process. I realize this process isn't for everybody. Not everyone is doing social media memory keeping, but it's something I really enjoy, and I just thought I would show you guys how it goes. All right, I will make sure to list everything that I use down below if I can find it online. Some of the sticker books I've pulled are a little bit older, so I'll see if I can find those. Otherwise, I will put you all on fast forward. Let's go. So I actually saw another YouTube content creator have one of these, a memory planner for the content that she creates on YouTube. And I thought it was a fantastic idea. So when you create things and put it out there in social media, it's definitely kind of opening yourself up to criticism, especially here on YouTube, but also on Instagram. And I don't get a lot of negative comments, but I definitely get a few here and there. And it always is interesting to me just how much the negative comments stick out more than the positive. I get a ton of positive comments and I love reading all of your comments and I always try to respond to everything. But when you get those negative ones, they can really stick with you. And so I thought that this planner was an excellent way not only to just document the things I'm doing. I mean, content creating is a big part of my everyday life. So documenting that part and then documenting all of the sweet things that get written as comments on Instagram and on YouTube. Some of you just write me the sweetest little notes and I love getting to read them and put them in here. And I just think it's an interesting exercise to document those particular times. And so I've really enjoyed working on this project this year. As you notice, the first thing I did was cut out the pictures from Instagram. So I actually just screenshot pictures from Instagram and then edit them. I print them out four to a sheet on a 4x6 photo paper from my photo printer and then cut it out from there so that I have these small 2x3 photos. And then I use the thumbnails from my YouTube videos. So I create a unique thumbnail for every YouTube video and I print those off 2 inches wide, and I think it turns into just over an inch tall, just as a documentation of what YouTube video went up that day. And so that's what I use as my like photos or the basis. And then what makes this memory keeping different from my other planner memory keeper is that I just use stickers. I just go with Happy Planner stickers for the most part and use that to decorate. It is super easy, super simple. I try not to overthink it. For instance, I always put the YouTube thumbnails in the same place directly under the day. There's times that I have 2 videos that are released in one day. And in that case, I just stack them right there, one on top of the other, and they fit nicely in those boxes. And then I just have fun playing with bright stickers. Generally, I go with a bright theme. This week, I'm using mostly a memory keeping happy planner, and then I will go back and get some stickers out of the journaling happy planner, which is those are super cool because they're white stickers. They're all black and white. They're easy to color on. And so if you like doodling or you like having a journal and being able to incorporate a few illustrations here and there, that is an awesome example or an awesome resource for you to use. I try to make sure that I have plenty of space to write. So something I always do would be with these larger stickers. I like layering them behind photos, but I don't want to cover up all of the lines. And so I generally will cut them off and then reuse that little part. And that kind of brings a more cohesive look to the page. I mean, I don't worry too much about these pages being cohesive, but you get to see those florals peek out in multiple parts of the page, which is nice. And I do the same thing over here. I have just a really pretty, this is on a clear sticker paper, so it'll just meld right into the page. And I'm just gonna cut it in half to start with in a pretty straight line. And then I can layer it in a couple of places. It won't take up all of the lines in either place, but you get that feeling of the florals and it's moving the pink around the page. So I really like that look. Today, I'm using my Tombow Permanent Tape Runner as my primary adhesive. Normally, I would use my ATG tape glider, but honestly, it ran out of its roll and I just didn't have the patience to change out the roll. If you have one of those tape guns, you know what I'm talking about. It's not the easiest thing to change out the adhesive in those adhesive tape gliders. So it can be done and I'm getting much, much better at it, but I just wasn't having the patience for doing it today. So I just stuck with my regular old Tombow permanent adhesive because it just is so easy to swap out when you run out. A little more expensive, but I really enjoy it. At this point, I have all of the larger elements planned out on the page. So you can see I chose several boxes that I could layer kind of behind different Instagram photos so that I could write comments in there. And then I had those florals and a large quote that says something wonderful that'll fill up that bottom area. And then what I'll do is come back and layer with some more stickers, but generally I layer those on top. So I try to lay out my photos first, decide if I'm going to have some stickers that layer underneath. And if I do, I get those down on the page and then try to get everything else stuck on the page before I come back with all of these smaller stickers, Insta-worthy. That one is perfect for the spread. And I'm just going to layer in a few little stickers here and there just for fun. I love all of these cameras. I used them all up on this page. This is just a fun, really versatile book. So this is actually a memory keeping sticker book. So it's sized for a big size happy planner, but a lot of the pieces you can use in multiple happy planners. And it's a pretty versatile book. It talks a lot about capturing memories and fun times. And so I really like that it's not necessarily seasonal because I'm not usually a seasonal scrapper. I just go with pretty things that I like. So I'm loving just picking pieces here and there. I do decide that I want to cover up. So many of the boxes that I chose have words like today or noted, and I wasn't really digging that. And so I do end up covering up most of those in various ways. So for instance, this one right here says one of a kind and it layers over on top of the photo. And then I love this one that says I love life and it will layer over there on that box. As I get close to wrapping up this particular spread, I decide that I do want to have a sticker that kind of accompanies or layers each of the different videos that I did last week. So I chose that little pink semicircle. I think it'll be fun to jot in a few notes right there. I kind of play with the stickers. I pick some up, put some down, and then I'm looking for some smaller stickers that I can use to kind of layer on top of some more of these different pictures. So I love the snapshot one. It has some of that gold foiling that is in the quote that's at the bottom right. So bringing it over to the left side of the spread works out really nicely. And snapshot is a great phrase for that particular day. And now I'm going to look into this journaling one again. I love that these are paper stickers, so you can color on them. Some of them have foiling. They just work really great, like I said, for journaling. Love the little typewriter. So I like being able to kind of stick the stickers in all of these nooks and crannies. You guys know I'm a more is more kind of scrapper and kind of crafter. I like to fill in all of the spaces, and it looks like there's white space on here, but I will go back and write in different comments and things later on. I just didn't want to do that on screen. And these hearts are perfect. So I will use the hearts around the whole page. It definitely brings it together because it's a repeated element. And sometimes these can feel a little scattered, these particular spreads, because I am just using random stickers, random pieces that I like. So having at least one element that goes throughout works really well. And so these black and white stickers are kind of providing me with that in this particular spread. So making sure each of the videos has some little element, and then I am done. Okay, so here is the finished product. I will come back through and fill in all of the space with comments that people left on Instagram and on YouTube. But it's just a fun way to document my work life, things that I create and things that I care about. And so I think it's a fun way to focus on the positive as well. So thank you so much for watching today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider hitting that subscribe button as well as the bell notification button. Don't forget, there are links down below to check out if you are interested in any of these products. I hope that you have a fabulous day, and as always, keep it creative.